All right. To my dear brothers, forward sons, I'm going to make this video because today was my turn to speak at the forward sons dinner. And today is the 13th of March, 2020. But because of the coronavirus scare, we did not have the meeting. It was canceled. Therefore, I will make this effort to give this information to my brothers in the church, of the New Jerusalem, and to my brothers, forward sons. Today is weather in Toronto kind of +4, but it feels like -1. Not the best. And almost half of March. And in March is supposed to be the beginning of the spring. In any case, this program I will call The Earth is Flat. So I will talk about that. I will give you 30 points why I say so. And some of the points you might understand very easy. Some of the points you might not understand. But anyway, hear me out in any case and decide for yourself. So today it was 9:47 when I started, PM evening, and you will get this video probably to watch in the morning because when I finish it and when I put it to the YouTube and then I share it with you, I send it to you. It will be too late probably for today, but in the morning, tomorrow is Saturday, you can watch it or whenever you have time. Okay, so I will give you then something. Patrick Horrigan asked me to say something about myself and about my ministry for the Lord. Regarding Emanuel Swedenborg, let me say then something about myself in that regard. My ministry is on the YouTube. Sometimes I have live programs, sometimes I have just I record it and then I send it to people that watch me or they just find it out by themselves and they watch it. So in that regard, let me tell you what I am doing. I always have Emanuel Swedenborg. I am doing programs mainly in the Serbian language. And my channel is called Darling Dragan Balotic, or in English you would say Balotic because you don't know how to pronounce chi. Okay, some of you do know. I have these programs. I have made programs Flat Earth, 69 programs in Serbian language and 4 programs in English. I have made 91 programs True Religion in Serbian. And Swedenborg's name is always exhibited in my programs. If you go to YouTube, you put my name, you will find that I am there, but you will find that I'm speaking in a different language. But you can see that I am talking about Emmanuel. And what else I can tell you about that? Views, I have views from 300 people in a week to 40,000 people. Like my best video is 41K. 41,040 people was like I was watching 2 days ago. It was like about over 41,000 views. That was for my program that I made on the 31st of January 2018. Yeah, that video is about flat Earth, and it has over 41,000 views. Let me tell something else. I do have good education, therefore I want you, some of you, to for whom that is important, you can trust that I have about 3 university degrees. So I should know what I'm talking about, although that is not a guarantee. We have many educated people who don't know nothing about nothing. But I am saying that for those to whom that means something. I am a electrical engineer. It is specialization in electronics and telecommunications. I have a master's degree. Bachelor's degree in electrical engineering. I have the master's degree in theology, and all A's. I was straight A student. And what else I can tell you? Yeah, I have finished the 3rd year of theological school in Bryn Athyn, Pennsylvania, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. So I would like, and I would be a missionary for the church if the church had more interest in missionary work. I contacted 2 churches, the General Church and the Church of the Lord's New Church, which is of Nova Hierosolima. I have not found a very good response yet from any of them, even though I did it last year. I would not need much support because I do have pension. I have condominium in Serbia, Belgrade, and I have the house, and I would not need much support, if any, maybe a little bit for hotel or something like that. But anyway, still the interest was not there for some reason. I'm just saying something like that you may know. I am willing to be a missionary for Emanuel Swedenborg and his writings. I find them absolutely amazing, perfect, beautiful. There is nobody better than him. And I would like to promote his writings to the country where I was born. That is Serbia, and to all countries around. There are many countries around also that used to be part of the ex-Yugoslavia. They speak the same language, or some of them almost the same language. So I have there a lot of people that are interested. I have 300 to 600 people, let's say about 500 people I have in a week on average. In 1 week, later on, there more of them watch my programs. So basically I have audience of about 500 people interested in true religion, interested in Emanuel Swedenborg's true religion. So, but anyway, that's about that. So, but now I will go to my main theme for this evening, and that is 30 proofs. I have many more, but I will give you this evening 30 proofs that the Earth is flat. Okay, I will tell you, first proof is that the water level is always flat. You cannot find water that is not flat, on the small scale or on the big scale. The water is always flat. To prove that is very easy. I will give you one way how to prove. It has been done many times before me, but I will show you how to do it easy. Sometimes I will look at my notebook to remind myself what I need to speak about, that I may not forget. It goes like this. Okay, I remove this one also for now. Okay, if we have, it has been done on the, I will use a standard example of the old Bedford. It was done by a person in the 19th century already. His name is Samuel Robotham. Okay, let me see here if I make any, Robotham, R-O-W-B-O-T-H-A-M, Samuel, you know, he wrote a book, Earth is Not a Globe, but he made this experiment. He did like this, okay, this was, I will exaggerate the curvature of the Earth, that it may be obvious. He was watching from here, 8 inches above the water, because we have a formula for the curvature of the Earth, which of course it does not exist, but I'm just using the formula that we have, scientific formula. The curvature, it's like this. Let's say height. That would, if I look through it, this height would be like this. It is 8 inches. 8 inches times number of miles squared. So, after 1 mile, okay, there is a, this is representing here a canal, straight, totally straight, everything visible, no disturbances. So, by this formula, this means if we have 8 inches, after 8 inches, I would hit the Earth. I would not be able to see more than 1 mile around myself, because the curvature of the Earth is supposed to be 8 inches every mile. So, if we go, so this is 6 miles. 1 mile, 2 mile, 3 mile, 4 mile, 5 mile, 6 miles. So in this case, because I am 8 inches above the ground, my camera, my telescope, I am watching from telescope, and I have a boat going straight, and we are expecting this curvature to have on the ground, exaggerated in this place, but curvature should be there, noticeable, if the Earth is a ball. So, after 2 miles, this here, this height should be 30, it's a number of miles 2 times 8 inches, it would be 32 inches. 32 inches. Okay. Because I am here, okay, this is wrong, because I am not on the level here of the ground, So this will be, sorry, this would be 8 inches. That is a mistake. Okay, this is a mistake. It will be still 8 inches here, because that's because I'm going this way. Okay, second mile from this will be 32 inches. Third mile will be 8 inches times 3 square. 3 times 8. 9 times 8 is 72 inches or 6 feet. It would be like my height. A person, my height, you could not see after 3 miles. You could, because of the curvature supposed to be of the earth. So after 4 miles here, you would have curvature. Let me see here. It would be 10 feet and 8 inches. 10 feet and 10 feet and 8 inches. 8 inches. And here, the curvature would be 16 feet and 8 inches. 16 feet and 8 inches. Okay. So in other words, here is a bridge. Here is a bridge, and here is like this, and the boat is going with a flagstaff 5 feet in the air, 5 feet high above the level of the water. If I can see this boat here, that would mean that the earth is flat. If I don't see this boat, that means that the earth is curved, and that's why I don't see it. Because if I go like this, look, the line of sight, I will be here. When I come here, or my height would be 16 feet, 8 inches. The boat was with the flagstaff only 5 inches, so my boat would be like 5-6 meters down under the line of sight. So that means that if I see it, there is no curvature. If I don't see it, then there is a curvature. We are looking through a telescope. Okay, now. Let me now tell you. We have was looked, and we have seen the boat. So we see the boat. That means there is no curvature. This is a very simple way how to prove that there is no curvature of the earth, because we see boat. We are not, the line of sight is not so far above the boat. The second thing I will do maybe in the end, how to do another experiment. I don't want to spend too much time on this point to elaborate it. This is very simple. Anybody can do it. Anybody can do it. The other experiment I will show maybe later. If I am too long, I will not show, but if I am short, I will. So is water level or is it not? We asked an astronomer, and he replied, practically yes, theoretically no. In other words, he is saying, yes, practically water is level, but theoretically it should not be. Whenever you have something like no harmony between theory and practical observations, you always keep practical observations. This is much more powerful than theory. Theory, if it does not go along with practical observations, is a wrong theory and should be cast out. So in this asking this astronomer, he answered very smart, like practically yes, theoretically no. That is found in a book by William Carpenter, 100 proofs the Earth is not a globe. Okay, that now the problem with the water that they say that the water is held by gravitation around the Earth. Okay, this is the Earth. This is the Earth. So this is the biggest hoax ever that has been made. The Earth does not look like this, but I'm telling you what is official shape of the Earth. I will give you 30 reasons why it is not so. Yeah, this is the hoax that is perpetrated on all of us. Now, okay. The problem is we don't have a model, we don't have a practical example of keeping water stuck to the surface of the ball on a scale smaller than the planetary. So if we put water around this, it will go down. It will not be kept. Even if you make this out of very heavy metal, so the gravitation should be bigger. No, it will not keep the water. The water will go down. So they don't have any a good example, practical example to show us that one body, round body, spherical body can keep water on its surface. They are telling us that the Earth is doing so, but there is no proof to it, because I will, as you will see, destroy all the proofs of that. So, Earth, they say also this thing. The Earth is turning around its axis 1,000 miles per hour on the axis. So that's a lot of speed, kind of 1,000 miles. That's like faster than the airplane goes. Then they say that Earth is turning around the Sun 67,000 miles per hour. That is 32 times faster than the bullet speed. Then they say the Earth is turning 500,000 miles per hour around the center of the galaxy Milky Way. That is 230 times faster than the bullet speed. Then they say that the Earth is turning 60, not turning, but going away from the center of the Big Bang, 60, 670 million miles per hour. That is 310 thousands times faster than the bullet speed. Can you grasp the speed by which the Earth is turning every way? It's turning one way, then it's turning this way, then it's turning with the solar system, then it is turning away from the Big Bang. So it is turning in four different directions that they tell us. And yet the water stays stuck. Somehow the water miraculously stays stuck to the surface of the Earth. Who can believe that? So that's not reasonable, and they have no proof of any of those things. If they give any proof, give those proofs to me and see what happens. So that we can go then something maybe I can mention this, that many experiments were done by Dr. Robotham all over the earth using telescope, spirit levels, and theodolites. Theodolites are special precision instruments for measuring angles and horizontal or vertical planes. For measuring angles in horizontal or vertical planes. Very easy. Anybody can do that. So easy to do it. Does not cost much to do it. We can do it today. The rotundity of the Earth is a simple theory, having no foundation in fact. A pure invention of misdirected genius. Absolute falsehood, says Dr. Robotham. And I say the same thing. Okay, there is a Brazil team. They were 7 years investigating the shape of the Earth with all possible instruments, all scientists, great guys. And they have a program on YouTube called Convex Earth. The documentary, The Flat Earth Scientific Proof. If you want, you can find that program on this website. It's called convexearth.org. I don't know if I should write it. Maybe I will write it later, maybe not now. I'm wasting too much time, maybe writing too many things if I do so. And also in other languages, it's found in English also on the website called terraconvexa.com. That's a Brazilian website. So this video has 57,000 views. It was made in March 2018. It's 1 hour and 32 minutes. Who is interested into all ins and outs, how experiments were made, with what instruments, the best instruments the science can afford today, that it was done, and it was found that the Earth is flat. So this is not just me telling you. You can check up with other scientists also. Okay, let me give you some other proofs. I will go now a little bit faster maybe. Second proof is that horizon is always on a level with the eye. I wrote down some, that's why when you see I am looking down, I am reading what I wrote, so I don't forget. So we have balloons, amateur balloons, that have gone 121,000 feet above the ground. And horizon is always rising with the camera level perfectly flat, 360 degrees around. Anybody can prove that for themselves. You go, you rent a balloon, or you go, there are people who are in that business. You go with other people and see for yourself. And the Earth looks from balloon that is very high. No matter what height you are, the horizon is always on the level of your eyes. And the ground under you looks like a basin. It looks like a bowl or like a dish. So it looks like this. It looks like this. And then you are here above the ground, maybe 120,000 feet high. No matter how high do you go, the horizon rises up with you. If the Earth was round, the horizon would fall. The further you go look, it would fall down. It would not rise up with your eye level. So the third proof, you can see a ship 200 miles distant, 4 miles below the line of sight. If you look at ship, there are sailors who have seen ships, there are many cases. You can see a ship 200 miles away, with telescope, of course. And that means that if you can see that the level of water is flat, because if the earth was curved, the ship would be 4 miles below the line of sight. So I don't know if I should draw all those things. It would be nicer if I would, but I feel like this is my first presentation to you guys, and I want just to give you a taste of it. I don't have to explain to you everything. So just some basic facts of life. Lighthouses visible 40 miles away. Lighthouse that is 40 miles away. I think I still better draw a little bit. Lighthouse. Okay, let's say again, this is the earth and it's curved. So I am, okay, lighthouse is here. Okay, lighthouse. Okay, and then I am watching from here, from 40 miles away. So if the earth was curved like this, my line of sight would be like this, and my lighthouse would be 4 miles from the lighthouse to the line of sight. It would be impossible to see a lighthouse from 40 miles if the earth was curved. But because we see it, that means it is not curved. I go next. Fourth point. Airplane flies always in a straight line. If the earth was curved, the airplane would have always to dip as it goes distance. Every minute, the airplane would have to dip 800 inches or 66 feet or about 20 meters. So how I come to these figures? Very easy, very easy by this formula. Very easy to do so. Anybody who is interested, I will explain more in detail some other time. But believe me, in the meantime, and I have made no mistakes. Gyroscope. The airplane is always kept by gyroscope in the straight line. You know what is the purpose of gyroscope? To keep something always in the straight line. So when the airplane flies, it flies in the straight line. We have talked with pilots. They say to us, the earth is flat. They can see far away distances. If the earth was not flat, they would not be able to do so. We have talked with the air pilots also. Next point, cannon. Cannon bullet, or what is the name for the bullet of a cannon? Maybe there is a better word. But a cannonball, maybe that's better, cannonball falls back. If we shoot it straight up, it falls back in 28 seconds usually, not further than 2 feet from the place where it was fired from. So that means Okay, that would mean that the Earth did not move. If the Earth was moving, as they say, 1,000 miles per hour or 1,600 kilometers per hour on the equator, north and south of the equator, the speeds are smaller. But if we fire the cannon on the equator straight up, the ball goes 14 seconds up and 14 seconds down. That's 28 seconds. In that amount of time, the Earth would have moved, the surface of the Earth would have moved 12 kilometers. I have rounded those figures. I don't go exactly to meter. I have rounded the figures, but they are pretty much accurate. So that means because while you see, if I shoot cannon from here and it goes up and the ball comes back, sometimes fall exactly to the mouth of the cannon. But while the cannonball is going up and down, the Earth is moving. The Earth is moving. Actually, the Earth is moving from the west to the east. So, in other words, when the ball comes back, this place where the ball, where the cannon is, would have moved 12 kilometers to the west. So, actually, no. The cannon would have moved 12 kilometers to the east, and the cannonball would fall 12 kilometers west of the cannon. But because it falls exactly where the cannon was who shot it, that means the Earth is not moving. Number six. If the Earth was moving, there would be terrible winds on the surface of the Earth. Like the wind, let's say 1,000 miles per hour on the equator, and a little bit north, let's say where we live, it would move 1,000. No, like 700 miles per hour. Or 1,000 kilometers. So the Earth moves very different speeds depending where we are on the surface. On the equator moves much faster, and on the north moves with less speed, and on the North Pole it does not move at all. So it's standing in the spot. That's why I can tell you. No, I will not tell you that. I will keep simple. Okay, so do you understand what I said? The winds would be terrible because the atmosphere is not connected with the Earth. There is no solid connection of the atmosphere to the surface of the Earth. The gravitation cannot keep it so fast to the Earth because gravitation cannot keep even a butterfly from flying, and chimney smoke goes up. The atmosphere is not able to pull it down. I mean, the gravitation is not able to pull it down. So how can it pull down all of the atmosphere? It's a ridiculous proposition. Next point is number seven. Stars never change their paths. Never. The stars always go around. The stars are moving around the North Star. North Star is there just above the center of the Earth, which is North Pole. North Pole is in the center of the Earth. Let me show you how the Earth looks. The Earth looks like a pizza. This is the Earth. This is pizza. Above that is dome that keeps us safe and that keeps atmosphere enclosed that we breathe. And it's protecting us from many other things. So, because this, so this is North Star here, straight above North Pole. This is North Pole in the middle. North Star is here, and it never changes its position. And the dome rotates always the same way. So the stars do not change their paths ever. And the North Star never moves from the center of the Earth. It's always above the center of the Earth. Now, if you remember, if the Earth was moving around its axis and then around the Sun and with the Sun around the center of the Milky Way and then going away from the Big Bang, that would mean that the stars would change always position in relation to the Earth. Since they do not change their position ever, they stay there for centuries and millennia the same, that means the Earth is not moving. Okay, so stars never change their paths. Eight. Let me give you a number eight. Arctic and Antarctic have vastly different climates. Arctic average temperature on Arctic is plus 4 degrees Celsius. The average temperature on Antarctic is minus 13 degrees Celsius. That is a big difference. So why is that? If the Earth is ball like this, it should be the same thing, because in this position, this is Sun here. Let's say it goes like this: the South Hemisphere would be under the Sun. Here would be summer. Here would be winter. 180 days later, it would be like this. In this position, Sun would be here. So now the summer would be on the North Hemisphere. South Hemisphere should have winter. So the climate should be the same, because everything is the same. North and South, they are the same amount of time turned towards Sun and away from Sun. So there should be no difference in climate. Howbeit, there is a big difference. And on Arctic, we have 800 plants in summer. On Antarctic, 68 degrees parallel. Below that, south of that, nothing grows. That, why is that? Because this is the Sun, this is the Earth. And Sun goes like this. And in the summer, it goes close to the North Pole, and in the North so-called hemisphere, we have, it's not hemisphere, but I'm calling it so-called, we have summer here. When we are December, the Sun moves all the way to Capricorn, and then the South, it's closer to South, so it's far from the North, and that's why we have here now winter, and they have summer in the South. So that's but this is very cold here. This is Antarctica. Ice is Antarctica. It's not a pole, it's a belt. Let's go next. I could elaborate on that much more. Number nine, Sun goes much faster in the south than in the north. You see that again, I have to show here. Sun goes, has the same amount of time, 24 hours to make a circle. When it is summer on the north, Sun makes a small circle around the North Pole, and therefore it goes slow. In the winter, the sun is in the south here. It has to go much longer distance, much bigger circle in the same amount of time. That's why it goes much faster. So the sun changes speed, the sun changes height from the earth, distance from the earth. The sun changes all the time. So you see, that here in the south, in the north, sun goes slow. In the south, it goes much faster because it has to cover much greater distance. And that's why we have situation that in the north, we have a morning sunrise and sunset. They last like, let's say, eventide. It lasts 1 hour till the night comes. In the morning, dawn, lasts 1 hour till the day comes. But in the south, because the sun goes much faster, you have in 5 minutes finished the morning and dawning. 5 minutes, it's the sun very high, and it's already day. And in the evening, you have sunset very fast, and the night comes suddenly. In less than 5 minutes, night comes. You guys who have been in New Zealand and maybe somewhere close to the so-called South Pole, you know, and of course sailors know that very well, that the night and the day, they come very fast because the sun goes much faster. That is the evidence of that is well known to the sailors of the world and to people who live in the south, far in the south. Let's go 10th point. South hemisphere distances are much bigger. Yes, distances are much bigger. You have enormous distances, enormous water surfaces. The sailors have big problem when they believe in the globe. They come to very different and wrong places. But the sailors have learned their lesson, and they don't go by globe because they would be lost. They go by this, the flat earth map. So, yeah, they tell us distance between, Buenos Aires and Johannesburg. It's much bigger than they tell us. And then different distances between Johannesburg and Sydney is much bigger than they tell us. And we know that. We know by the amount of hours that airplanes fly. It's much bigger than what is case on the globe, would be case on the globe. Okay, again, I go to the next point. Illogical flight routes. Okay, we have like this. If we go, let's say, from Buenos Aires, and we go let me take one example here. I know for sure. Let me take Johannesburg going to Sydney. It goes like this. I don't know if you can see me here. Johannesburg here. It goes up, 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 up. It goes to the Dubai. And from Dubai, it goes down, 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 down to Sydney. It makes no sense. It is much further. It would use much more fuel, much more time. There is no reason to go from Johannesburg to Sydney to go like this, and then to go down like this. Makes no sense. But on the flat earth makes perfect sense. Because on the flat earth, let me show you, on the flat earth, okay, on the flat earth, Johannesburg, Sydney, I should have had something to show you, something, okay, let me use this one. Look, Johannesburg, Sydney, it's a straight line, and it goes, it goes over Dubai. You see, it's a Johannesburg, Dubai, Sydney is a straight line. That's natural way to fly, the shortest way on the flat earth, not on the globe. On the globe makes no sense, and yet those are the routes that airplanes fly. They don't fly they don't fly like on the globe. Like on the globe, they would fly just like this. This is totally unreal. But they would fly like this. Look, it would be very easy. Johannesburg, and then fly to Sydney. Very easy, see? And very short. It's not true. It goes all the way up and then down. Why? Because that is the straight line on the globe. The other route, let me see if I have written down the other route. Santiago de Chile, Sydney. Aha. Santiago de Chile and Sydney. Okay, let me show you this one too. Santiago de Chile is here. South America. And he's going to Sydney, Australia. So it would, on the globe, it would be very easy. You go here and here. No big deal. But instead, this is how that flies. Santiago de Chile goes to Los Angeles all the way up. And then from Los Angeles goes down to Sydney. So makes no sense. On the globe, it is much further. There is no reason to do that because there are airplanes that fly from Los Angeles to Sydney. These guys don't need to pick up some passengers to go so much further to pick up some passengers, because there are airplanes, American, that fly directly from Los Angeles to Sydney. So this is not the reason, picking up passengers. The reason is this, because that is the shortest route. Let me show you, where did I put my, here. See, again, Santiago, okay. Okay, you see, this is South America. This is Santiago de Chile. And we go to Santiago de Chile, we go to Sydney, you see? And Los Angeles is on the way. It's a straight line. Santiago de Chile, Los Angeles, and Sydney. It's a straight line on the flat earth. That's why it flies that way, because the earth is flat. It is not a globe. That's why they fly that way. I go further. Point 12. North Pole, a long 24-hour days, many days, like for many days, months, the sun does not go down. It's a day. It's a day that lasts several months. Okay. On the South Pole, day is never 24 hours. Why is that? I tell you why. This is the Earth. And this is the North Pole. And the South Pole is this here, what you see, white ice around the pizza Earth. So when the sun is, when we have summer, the sun is going around the North Pole like this. And the sun is making a day on the North Pole, never goes down, because the rays of sun go all the time on the North Pole. So the North Pole day lasts several months. But when it is in the south, when we have winter and they have summer, you see what happens. If you are here, let's say, the sun comes and goes. Your day lasts several hours and then it's gone. It's night. The sun comes again. The day starts. Noon, night, gone. Night. So we never have 24-hour day on the South Pole. If the Earth was a globe, as they tell us, the on the South Pole, we should have summer for many months also, because it's the same thing in position towards the sun. South Pole and North Pole should have the same thing happening. Because what is happening to the North Pole, 6 months later, will be happening to the South Pole. It's not true. That's why I'm telling you. The Earth is not a ball. We go number 13. Did I say already North Star never moves? I think I mentioned that. Always in the same position. North Star never moves. If the Earth was moving so much around its axis, around the sun, with the solar system, around the Milky Way, with the Milky Way, away from the center of the Big Bang, so the North Star would change a lot its position. It never changes. That's the reason why I say the Earth does not move. The Earth does not move at all. Okay, we go next. North Star Polaris. Aha, that's interesting. North Star or Polaris, they say, is 323 to 434 light years distant. So that's a long way, like more than 300 light years away from the Earth, they say. Of course, this is ridiculous to say, because that would be a terrible waste of space. God is not so stupid and inefficient. That's not the case. But this is interesting. Difference between 323 light years and 434 light years, when she is furthest away from us, is 666,000 billion miles. That is the signature of the devil. 666. It's not by chance. They did not say for nothing the 323 light years to 434 light years distant. They have planned it, and it comes to 666, and that is the signature of the Satan. So that's not by chance. If you calculate that, I'm not going to calculate it now, just believe me. In the meantime, that is the distance in miles, in comparison with the distance in light years. Okay, number 14. The Earth axis is on 23.4 degrees. You see, they say the Earth is, you see this axis? The axis is 23. In comparison to the vertical line, the Earth is 23.4 degrees inclined. So the rest of the angle to the 90 degrees angle is 66.6 degrees. Again, the six signature of the devil, 66636. They have determined on purpose that the axis of the Earth is this this angle. That is not by chance. Of course, it has nothing to do with that. There is no angle of the Earth, and there is no sphere, there is no ball. This is all, may I say, BS. But I am telling you, I am using their language, and I am using their telling us the facts, their facts, that they are lying to us. 15. North Star visible from 20 degrees south. This makes no sense. I told you, North Star is straight above the North Pole. And if I am 20 degrees, let's say I am here, maybe let's say Buenos Aires. I am here. How can I see North Star? I couldn't, any place under the equator, I should not be able to see, because there is a curvature. I would have to see through the Earth in order to see North Star. Because we are seeing it, that means it's not the ball. It is something else. So, north-south flight around the globe is impossible. All the airplane fly west, east, east, west. Nobody can fly south to north and around the ball. Nobody ever has done that. They can deceive us, and they can say, okay, I fly to the Arctic, and then they say, oh, I have flown the other side, and I come again to the same place. No, what they do, they go to the Arctic, and then change the direction and go back where they started, and then they say, oh, we have been around. Nobody has been around. The flight north, south is impossible on the Earth. Why it is impossible? Because the Earth is like a pizza. And when you come to the edge of the Earth, you hit the dome. You cannot go beyond it. So we know also that close to the edge of the Earth, airplanes can fly very low. They cannot fly high because the dome is closed. So that fact is also known. 17. Photos of the Earth by NASA do not exist. Not one. Not one photo of the Earth exists, and yet they say they have been to the moon so many times, they have been to the Mars, they have so many flights, they go all over our solar system, and yet they don't have one photo picture of our Earth to show. All those pictures are CGIs. CGI means computer-generated images. If you don't believe me, go and check up for yourself. Also, they are so dumb. On those pictures, you can see the Earth, and you can see Mercator's map, meaning Greenland is big, you know, and the North is very big, which is not true. If the Earth is a globe, then the Greenland is much smaller. So, but they don't, they are not smart enough to remember that they show map on the earth when they make CGI, they show Mercator's map, which is totally inaccurate, which is not so in the nature. The camera would never see it that way from the space. It would see the real dimensions and not those that are demonstrated on the maps, which are, as we know, inaccurate. And also, if you watch their pictures from the space, depending which year, 2002, 2003, 2004, they are all different. On some pictures, the USA is big, like taking half of the hemisphere, northern hemisphere, like almost, actually almost all is USA. On others, it's smaller, which should be much smaller. So they are like, they don't know, they are not smart to give us always the same picture. But every year, the picture and the size of the continents is different. On one picture, they have even some ugly words written. So they are making fun of us. Okay. Well, I can tell you. On some picture, they have word spelled S-E-X. Okay. So these guys are very stupid. They don't know even how to deceive well, but they are like children. Okay, 18. Nobody ever was on the moon. NASA lies. About that, I could tell you a lot of facts. I will control myself and I will not. Just I am telling you, take it or leave it. We have never been on the moon. NASA has done all those flights in studios. And when they go in the air, when the rocket goes in the air, you can see very soon the rocket starts going down and goes into ocean. Cannot go very, very far and then has to go down. And those astronauts that come down, they bring them. This is not shuttle. This is like we have pictures. It's an airplane. So it comes down and lands on the water, and then we pick them up and so on. This is all made up. 19. Real shape of the Earth is like pizza. North Pole is in the center. Yes, those, that's I told them. I told you before, this is the Earth. It looks like a pizza. And the North Pole is here in the middle. South Pole does not exist. South Pole is a belt around the Earth, and it's called Antarctica. Antarctica is not a pole, a spot. It's a belt. It's a very large belt, over 100,000 kilometers in length. Okay, so that's I tell you that. Well, let me tell you also this. The sun is approximately 50 kilometers in diameter. Moon also. They are, sun and moon, they are the same size. 50 kilometers in diameter. The earth is from one end to the other. The earth from here to here is 40,000 kilometers. From here to here is 40,000 kilometers. Sun is 800 times smaller in diameter than the Earth. The Earth is much bigger than the Sun. Okay. The sun also changes distance from the earth, different times, different distance, but it's about 500 kilometers, and it can go down much closer to the earth. So the sun is maximum 500,000, no, 5,000 kilometers. What did I say? Sorry, I'm making some mistakes. Sorry for that. 5,000 kilometers maximum. And there are times when it is closer to the earth. So it's not 150 million kilometers away. That is blah, blah, blah. Has nothing to do with real world. Let me show you. Oh, like, and the stars. The stars are like about 500 meters in diameter. They are small. They are not big. Like, but they say that the stars are much bigger than the Earth and than the Sun. They say that the Sun is bigger than the Earth 1,300,000 times. That's how many Earths can you put into Sun. But they also say that there are stars who are 90 million times bigger than the sun. It's a big lie. The stars are about 500 meters and they are lights in the sky, in the dome. Okay, the moon is 20. The moon is transparent. We see stars through it. Yes. Many times we can see stars behind the moon, and when the moon moves, we see the star that we saw through the moon. So moon is transparent. So what they are there, they are saying that the moon is a solid matter. Well, not always. Sometimes it's just transparent. 21. Moon's light is cold. It's not the reflection of the sun's light. They say that the moon has light as a reflection from the sun's light. That's not true. The sun's light is golden, yellow, warm. The moon's light is silvery and cold. If we have measured the temperature, you measure temperature in the sunshine. In the shadow, it's less temperature than in the sunshine. But with the moon, it's opposite. In the shadow, it is higher in the shadow of the moon than where moon shines. So the moon is taking away the temperature. The moon is cold. The light from the moon is cold. The light from the sun is warm. So that's a big difference. Sun and moon have nothing in common that way. Moon is not reflecting the sun, the sun's rays. 22. Vacuum does not exist. Vacuum does not exist. Vacuum, if they say this is the earth, and here is the atmosphere of the earth, and beyond that is vacuum, and the temperature minus 273 degrees. Now, if that was the case, this vacuum would pull out our atmosphere in an instant, because the vacuum is terribly strong. Oh, you can see picture. Vacuum is terribly strong. And it breaks the metallic things. If you... that's going too far. So, also, if the temperature was minus 273 degrees, as they say, the atmosphere would be pulled out and our Earth would freeze almost instantly, because that's a terrible minus 273 degrees. That is unimaginable. And that's what they have thought out for us, imagined for us. It has nothing to do with real life. Okay, so vacuum does not exist, because if it did, it would destroy the Earth instantly. 23. Sun's and moon's reflection in the water on a lake or on in the sea or on the ocean is a straight line. If that means the surface is flat. If the Earth was curved, we would see the sun just in one spot. We would see the sun of ray in one spot, and that's all. We would not see it all the length, going all the way to the sun on the horizon. So, because that is the situation, that means that the surface is flat. A round surface would not do that. Uh, 24. Flight from Toronto to Belgrade lasts the same amount of time as from Belgrade to Toronto. I am mentioning this route because I travel often that way. I have done it quite a number of times, and it takes the same time to fly in one direction as in the other. So let me explain you. If the Earth, okay, let's go here. Okay, this is, I'm looking, this is Toronto. This is Toronto, and I am flying to Belgrade. Belgrade is here. Toronto, Belgrade. If I go from Toronto to Belgrade, because they say the Earth is moving this way, let's say 1,000 kilometers only. So that means, but my airplane is flying 900 kilometers per hour. That means the Earth is going always faster in front of me. I would never reach Belgrade, because the Earth is turning and taking away Belgrade from me. You see? So I would never reach Belgrade unless I have very fast airplane. So if I fly from Belgrade to Toronto, then because the Earth is coming towards me, Toronto is coming towards Belgrade, then I would come to Toronto very fast, in several hours, because the flight does not take much less time from Belgrade to Toronto, but it takes the same time. That means that the Earth is not moving. The Earth is not turning. So it takes the same time, means there is no movement. Uh, 25. Sailor testimony. I have a friend, I have talked with him. He is a military officer, and he works on the Adriatic Sea. That is the sea that is close to where I was born. He says he has seen many times from one island that is 400, it's called Lastovo. It's 400 kilometers away from Montenegro. He says that he sees very plainly the coast of Montenegro from that island, 400 kilometers away approximately. So that would be impossible if the Earth had a curvature. The coast of Montenegro would be 14 kilometers below the line of sight. Remember, the earth goes like this, they say, I am looking here to here. I see here from here. But the line of sight goes like this. And from here to my line of sight is 40 kilometers. There is no way that I could see 400 kilometers away something if the earth was curved. Because I see, that means the earth is flat. That's why I can see. If the earth goes like this, then I can, from here, I can see here. Because there is no hump between me and this place. Also, we can see mountains from the coast of former Yugoslavia. We can see mountains and coast of Italy. If the earth was curved, we should not be able to see it because the mountains of Italy should be under the line of sight. We should be deep down. We should not be able to see them. We do see them. Okay, 26. Flight through vacuum is impossible. There is no air against which to push the rocket. So when they tell you that they fly through the vacuum, that's a story. That's a story. Don't believe it. Let them demonstrate it to you that it is possible. Then believe them if they can. 27. Point 27. Gravitation has never been proven. There is no proof that two masses attract each other. Never has been proven. There is an attraction force. There is a force, but it is not the so-called gravity. Isaac Newton never believed in gravity. I read his words. I read what he wrote. And he said that such force is impossible. These are his words. Because there is no medium through which to act the force. There is no medium through which to act. Especially you can imagine in vacuum. There is no medium through which the force can act on something in front of it. So all solar system held together by gravity goes to scrapyard. They put words in the mouth of famous people that they never uttered. Isaac Newton did not invent gravity. Has nothing to do with that apple falling on his head and then he realized there is gravity. There is something that is acting, but that is connected with the magnetic forces, with the density and with the ether. Not with gravity as they explain it. The masses do not attract each other. You can never prove that. You can put the smallest feather and bring it to the biggest mountain in the world. The mountain will not attract the smallest feather. There is no attraction between masses. That is all made up stuff. 28. Compass needle is attracted only to the North Pole. The opposite direction is so called South Pole. And the South Pole is 360 degrees in all directions. It is an Antarctica belt, not a spot. Not a pole. So that's it about that. 29. The Catholic Church burned people for globe earth. Like when they said that the earth is turning and they started to invent a heliocentric system. The church was burning. The Catholic Church was burning those people. Now they are siding with the so-called scientific community. They have changed their minds, unfortunately. But they have the biggest telescope in the world, whose name is Lucifer. Imagine, out of all names they could have called it, they call it Lucifer. If you believe in heliocentrism, that the sun is the center, then you are in the same company, the company of the Babylon the Great, the whore. As the Lord revealed to Emanuel Swedenborg that the Roman Catholic Church is. Do you want to be in that company? Do you feel confident that you are in the right company? See, they change their minds. This, that. They are not stable. Better consider geocentrism. That is, that the earth is in the center and not the sun. Sun is smaller than the earth 800 times in diameter. Imagine how small this, if this is 40,000 kilometers, sun is so small, you can hardly see it on the on this map. If we have sun, it's like a flashlight, a small one. So this is the real situation. And 30, the last point is this. I have offered $100 to anybody who can give me one valid proof that the earth is a ball, a sphere, and that is now for 2 years. Nobody came forward with some reasonable proof. I had some people coming forward and telling me that I should look at the Atlas. That's their proof. Atlas is their proof. You know, of course, Atlas is Atlas of the world. That is a ridiculous proposition, because we know that all atlases are false, and they are not a proof of anything. The same people who lied to us about landing on the moon made atlases too, or those who are globsters. They believe, those who believe in the globe and heliocentrism. The same offer is extended to you, my friends and brothers, at the Forward Sons group of people. This program is made expressly for you, but I will put it on the YouTube, and other people will see it too. Therefore, the offer is extended also to the random viewers who will find it also and be challenged by it. I want also to tell you in the end something from the Bible, because Bible is a proof also. Let me read to you, this is the, I am coming now to the end. Let me read Psalm 104, verse 5. You who laid the foundations of the earth, so that it should not be moved forever. God, who made foundation of the earth in such a way that the earth will not be moved forever. The earth is not moving. The Bible says it so. Well, some of you might say it has a spiritual meaning. Yes, it has spiritual meaning too, but it has a literal meaning also. Literally, it is true too. And let me give you another quote from the Bible, which is from the first epistle of Apostle John, chapter 5, verse 19. We know that we are of God, and the whole world lies under the sway of the wicked one. Or some translations even say the whole world lies in lies. So I will finish with this because the Bible and the Word of God tells us that the earth is non-moving. There are many references. I just gave you one. But our observations prove scientific, real scientific observation, not lying observation, not observations of liars, so-called observations. The real thing, very simple to repeat, you can prove that the earth is flat. So we have scientific proof, we have practical proof, and we have scriptural proof that the earth is flat, not a sphere, not a ball, and not moving. And the earth is the center and not the sun. Sun is just a small, insignificant, almost in comparison to earth. So now there are many more proofs that I can give to you. This is only a short version. And if you search YouTube for more, if you want to know in what kind of world we live, well, you will find out that what the Bible says is true. We live in a world that is full of lies. I have found out lies not just in the astronomy, not just about the globe, but I have found that there are lies in every area of human endeavor, in all sciences. I have found that astronomy is a lie, economy is a lie, religion is a lie, politics is a lie, physics also in many ways is a lie. Theory of relativity, Einstein's, is a lie. Geology is a lie. Archaeology is a lie. Mathematics is even a lie. I can show you that also. That's hard to believe, but yes, that there are lies there also. So many things. So I wanted you to know in what kind of the world you live. That is why we are talking about the flat earth. It tells you that you live in a world full of lies. You cannot trust nothing. You cannot trust medicine. Medicine is a lie. When doctors go to strike, funeral homes lose between 20% and 50% of business. In other words, people start dying less. So the medicine does not help us. It hurts us more than it helps us. That is the fact. That it's not me saying it, but the dean of the medical university in Chicago, Doctor, now I forgot his name. Sorry, I always knew. Now in this moment, I don't remember. He is saying it after being dean of the medical university for 25 years. He is saying that when doctors strike, people start dying less. When the doctors come back from the strike, the funeral homes regain the old business. In other words, people start dying more again. So with this, I will finish. Dear brothers, I want just here, I wrote a small greeting. I will not present you the proof I wanted because the video is too long. I will not present many other ways how to prove that the earth is flat. Very simple. I could have done that, but I don't want now. I just want now to say greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the God of heaven and earth. Amen. So now I will stop my video. Ciao, bye, God.